safe at any speed? Hagerty drives Ralph Nader's own Corvair. The Chevy Corvair has a reputation, one that is perhaps lost on a younger generation, but quite a few people will still reliably utter unsafe at any speed when they see a classic Corvair. The reason for this, of course, is Ralph Nader and number 39's landmark book of the same name that made a number of arguments against the Corvair and number 39's handling characteristics in one of its chapters. Although it and number 39's commonly believed the book is entirely about the Corvair, which it isn't, and number 39's. Nader and number 39's main argument against the Corvair dealt with the combination of a rear engine layout and a rear swing axle suspension that had the tendency to tuck under during certain maneuvers at certain speeds. The culprit, in the Corvair and number 39's case, was the lack of a standard antiroll bar. A 1965 redesign introduced a more advanced independent rear suspension that solved the camber issue, but the damage to the reputation of the car was done. Hagerty recently got their hands on not just a Corvair, but Nader and number 39's own car, to see just how unsafe at any speed it is. The results, well, you have to see for yourself. The Chevrolet Corvair became quite notorious by the middle 1960s. But in 1963 it was still a reasonably mainstream compact, selling in respectable numbers. Enough of these cars are still sitting. For decades, Corvair enthusiasts and unbiased audiences have pointed out the car was not significantly more unsafe than a lot of other cars on the market at the time. For example, the budget-priced Corvair No. 39's steering and dash were an No. 39. Adorned with the pointy chrome elements criticized by automotive safety advocates for the hazard they posed to passengers in the event of a collision, and the light Corvair had a much shorter stopping distance than a lot of American cars of the time. And, as Hagerty points out, the Corvair could actually make emergency turns when prompted to do so, more than could be said for some other chrome galleons of the day. So safety, even at the time, was not simply a matter of a rear-engined car being predisposed to oversteering. It and number 39's easy to assume that all cars sold by major automakers in the year 2016 would perform reasonably well in crash tests, but there are still plenty of regional markets filled with vehicles that. The book and the resulting media attention had an outsized effect on the field of automotive safety as well as the entire legal area of product liability. It effectively revolutionized both. As Hagerty points out, the example made of the Corvair forced automakers and consumers to re-examine car safety, starting the process of making changes to improve all cars. A couple of weeks back, I visited a private collection of thousands of old American cars in the High Plains region about 35 miles east of a certain Colorado mountain known for racing, in order to J. Ramey. Jay Ramey is an associate editor with Autoweek, and has been with the magazine since 2013. Jay also likes to kayak and bike. See more by this author. Classic Cars, Car Life, Car News, Video, Authors, Jay Ramey, but wait, there's more. Other news, recalls, coupe, sedan.